Welcome back. It is Friday and we are finishing up our third week of study. We will be wrapping up next week. I can't believe that Thanksgiving is almost here. It's almost upon us. I hope that your heart is already finding its way to a more thankful spot. As we kind of try to tie up this study with a bow, I just wanted to talk to you today about being thankful for the little things. So we are landing in the book of James in the New Testament. I know you're probably wondering, man, are we ever going to get to the New Testament? She's only done one New Testament story. But I feel like there was so much good that we could do in the Old Testament that it was beneficial for us. I think sometimes we want to jump right to the New Testament. And there's so much that God gave us in the first part of the canon of Scripture. So today we are in the book of James, and in verse 17, a very well-known verse, it says, "Every good and perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow or turning." Every good and perfect gift is from God. And sometimes we are very quick to thank Him for the big things. You know, I think about some of the big things that we have to thank God for this year. Our adoption went through, and that was a big thing we thanked God for. We had some great movements and some business things that we did. Those were a big thing to thank God for. But what about the little things? What about the day-to-day in and out things? Are we thanking God for those? Because every good and perfect gift is from above. Not just every big gift is from above. Not just every miracle is from above. No, every good and perfect gift is from above. God gives us little gifts every day. God blesses us in so many ways that it is hard for us to even think about them all. And are we taking the time each and every day to thank God for what He has done? So this part of our study is going to be a little short, but I hope that you will take some time today and just thank Him for the blessings that are in your life. Thank Him for the blessing of your children, for the blessing of your husband, for the blessing of your home, the things that maybe you forget to thank Him for each and every day because you're used to them. They are the norm, but they are still a gift, and they are still from God, and they are still part of your blessings. So make sure you take time to thank Him for every good and perfect gift. That includes the blue sky outside. I often call them Jesus hugs. They're little things that just remind me that Jesus is thinking of me. One of my favorites that I like to talk about often is Red Birds. When I was younger, I read a book, and I don't even remember the lady that wrote it. It was probably my first nonfiction book that I ever read, and it was called Red Birds, Rubies, and Rainbows. And basically, she was pointing out that we should be looking for these God moments in our lives, and she talked about how when she saw a red bird, she always felt like it was God's reminder to her that He loved her. And so red birds have always been special to me. I don't actually even like the color red, but every time I see a red bird, it reminds me to look for the God moments in my life. And it just reminds me that God loves me when I see these red birds. And, you know, then rubies just have always reminded me of Proverbs 31 and just being able to be industrious, and that's a blessing. And then rainbows obviously remind us of the covenants of God and the promises of God. And so look for those red bird, rubies, and rainbows in your life. The things that maybe are just God moments that remind you that God loves you. Those moments where God has asked you to be industrious or asked you to be virtuous, and they're hard, but they're worth it. And then those moments where God is keeping His promise to you. Every good and perfect gift is from above, even the little things. So remember to thank God and worship Him with your life.